Gianni and Becca.
And today, what are we talking about, Becca?
We are talking about earning God's love.
Can you earn God's love?
No.
No. No, you can't. And that's something that I think we often need a reminder of. In Romans, it talks about that, separating your who from your do. You may do things that God is not pleased with, but he's always pleased with you because you are in Christ. He's pleased with who you truly are. Mm-hmm. You might not do things that are Christ-like. You might not be doing things that he is happy about, but that doesn't change that he loves you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. I think that's something we get caught up on a lot.
Yeah.
Is that it's like, well, I have to do this. I have to be this. I have to, whatever the case is. And I think that I heard something the other day that was really cool. That was like, when you're sharing the gospel with somebody and you're talking to them about Jesus and just kind of where they're at, really nothing else matters. Like when you're like, okay, you know, so what do you think about this or whatever? And I think a lot of times we always have so many questions. It's like, okay, what about, you know, works? Or what about, you know, what do I have to change? What do I have to get out of my life now that I'm walking with you? You know, all these different things, all these and stuff. And I think that what was interesting was it was said, it doesn't really matter. I mean, all these things do matter. But the most important question is, who do you say that Jesus is? Right? It's like, who do you say that Jesus is? And so I think that a lot of times we think that we have to do all these things or earn all these things. And like, in reality, that's not true. Jesus wants us to admit that we are
fallen
short and so in need of a savior, and then just to trust him. That's literally what he asks for us to be in the kingdom of God. And he already loves you so much, already loves you. And I don't know, I just think we forget that a lot of times. But who do you say that Jesus is? That is the most important question. Everything else can be figured out later.
And it's so easy to criticize other people. Mm-hmm. When we're not separating their do from their who. Yeah. When we're not separating them from their actions. Mm-hmm. Their actions, their shortcomings, their faults, their sins, that's not who they are.
Yeah.
That's not them. So when we're looking at them and treating them as less than instead of still honoring them and loving them as a child of God,
mm-hmm.
we're not walking in love. We're not doing the things that God has called us to do because we can't earn God's love.
Yeah.
And if we're called to be like God, people shouldn't have to do things to earn our love either. We should just offer love. We should be free and easy to forgive, quick to forgive.
Mm.
We should be willing to smile and brush it off when somebody maybe says something they didn't mean. That doesn't mean we allow people to be super disrespectful or anything like that, but it means that we're walking in love.
Mm.
It means you can forgive somebody and know that they're bad for your life.
Yeah.
You can forgive somebody and know that they're not healthy for you to be around.
Mm-hmm.
Acknowledging that is important. Respect is important. But we also have to acknowledge where we're choosing not to forgive them. We're choosing not to do this and not to do that. And we're choosing to let their behavior influence how we treat them.
Yeah.
And that's not God's love. That's not a reflection of God's love either.
Yeah. Yeah. I think, too, we're kind of all on the same team here, right? We're all sinners. Every single one of us.
Literally every single person.
Literally every single person. Believer or non-believer. All sinners. The difference is Jesus. And I think that, I think all the times we forget that when we are so quick to look at somebody. I'm saying all of us.
Every single person.
Yeah. So quick to look at somebody and think, oh, well, goodness, or whatever the case is.
You're not really a Christian if you do this.
Right.
You're not really.
Right.
Just because they sin differently than you do. That's
right. That's
wrong.
Right.
That's not how that works.
Right, right. Yeah. We have all fallen short of the glory of God. And that's why it's so important that we need Jesus, because we cannot do it without Jesus.
Right.
And it's hard. Like it's, and that doesn't mean that when you come to know Jesus, that there's not going to be sin in your life
right.
or to be those days or those times when you look at people, like that. But because of Jesus, you are then able to walk in the fruits of the Spirit because of the Holy Spirit within you, that kind of helps you to not do that so well. To be able to look at the sin, you know, the block in your own eye before you, you know, look at someone else's. So.
Exactly. I love it. I love it. I love it. That's our challenge. Be love.